guys, I just wanted to quickly go over this Champion Lights background and make a couple of changes and show you how it works, add a photo, just give you a quick overview. So first of all, when you open it, this is the Photoshop one that I'm looking at. It has this dark edge layer. And if you have auto select layer turned on, a lot of times it's going to accidentally grab this layer. So what I like to do is I like to lock that layer. And you can still turn it off and on and decide if you want to use it or not. I also have some color balance. These are just things that I added that might make it easier for you to work with your photo. I love all these adjustments that you can do. This is the cooling filter, but you can actually change it to any of these. And then you can also increase the intensity. Right now it's not on, but in this one, I just automatically added, let me pull this out a little bit, a cool and a warm so that you could quickly turn those on. But you can also adjust them however you want, and you have all these choices. So it's kind of cool. All right, so then this is where I would suggest that you put your extracted player, but that's gonna depend on how you decide to use the template. I always like to include a player outer glow, but I also personally prefer to make one, and I'll show you how to do that. So that one I'll leave off. We have a brightness and contrast, just depending on your photo. You may want to use these, and you can also go in and adjust them however you want, just depending on how you want them to look. Again, I adjusted that with it off. Let me change it. So obviously you can, I like to exaggerate them so that I can kind of see what they do and then tweak it back. Hue saturation, you can change this background to any color to match what you're doing. Levels is another good one. You can adjust this middle slider, you know, just play around with these till you get what you want. And then the lights are in a folder for Photoshop, and they are not in a folder for Elements. The newer versions of Elements can handle folders, but the older ones cannot, and so that's why I keep it separate. But if you wanted to like move your lights all at once, you could change this to auto select group, and then it would move them all at once. So let me do Control Z to get that back where it was and go back to auto select layer. And I always like to have show transform controls on so that I can see what's going on. Okay. So your right lights, we have beams and we have lights. So, and you can change, turn those off or on. One thing I did with one of my samples was I turned this off, transform, flip vertical, and then auto select group. So I still am selecting my group, and then I brought it down here. And then I took the fog and I pushed it up. Is with this thing is if you have a layer selected and you want to move that layer, you can just turn this off and it's going to only stay on the layer that you selected. So you can quickly move things up and down, and it makes it a little bit easier. So I'm going to turn this one off. It got moved out of place. I can just scoot it over. And then you could put like a name or something up here with your text tool, and you can like, you know, put a style on it. So those are some fun features that you can do. And I want to make sure I have my history here so I can undo this stuff. All right, get back to where we were. Let's see my layers. Okay, sometimes I pull these out so I can see them a little bit better. The lights are a lot of fun to play with. And then the fog, you can adjust the opacity, layer backglow again, it's a different one, and then this is a haze. The crowd you can turn off. You have a darkened bottom, and then you can get into these layers that have different ground. And as far as what to do with these, they do have a hue. I did add a hue saturation to this one. Basketball. Again, these are not going to be in individual folders. The basketball one, another neat thing that you can do is you could change the color, which is kind of fun, but you can also desaturate it and darken it, which I think looks kind of nice. The grass layers, which you could use for any sport like soccer, rugby. For a sport that we haven't mentioned, you can always do black. And you can do black for any sport. You would have to adjust the fog to make it blend a little bit better. I think I prefer it with the fog, but so I might turn it down a little bit. There, now it blends pretty seamlessly. Now I'm going to open my player, which I have already, well, my boxer, which I have already extracted from the background. And I have tutorials on how to do that. Okay, so I'm going to pull him off to the side. I go in. Let me try it again. Actually, I didn't put it. I should have selected my layer right here, but anyway, I just moved it. So here I can add this. I could change the color to match and put this back in here if I want it red. And as far as his back glow, what I like to do is double click the picture, come to outer glow, white. Okay, and I make it as big as possible. Then I right click the effect, click create layer. Then I come to this layer and I do filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And then I just make it big, like really big. You can either do that again, or you can duplicate it if you want it brighter, or you can reduce the opacity if it's too bright. So you can kind of do it to your own taste. Okay, I think that's a pretty good overview of this product, and I hope you enjoy it.